to录音。Okay, yes. Okay, yeah, you can go ahead.
Great, thank you, Ping. Good morning, my name is Anna Brickman. I'm an attorney with Community Legal Services, and I'm here to talk about estate planning, powers of attorney, and healthcare proxies.
Okay, 大家好，她是叫 Anna Brickman， 她是从社区法律服务的律师。她今天过来讲呢，主要讲这个维租的规划啊，还有授权书啊，提前的医疗保健代理这些资料的。Okay.
I work for Community Legal Services. We provide free, so no cost legal services to low income residents of Philadelphia.
他是帮这个社区法律服务部门去工作了，他们是提供，他们为社区提供一个免费的法律的这个援助给那些在住在费城的低收入居民。Okay, you want to go to the next slide? So...
Yes, please. Yes.
Okay.
In addition to the estate planning work that I'm going to talk about today, Community Legal Services offers assistance with a broad range of practice areas. Nearly any area that you can think of, we work on. And so we encourage you, if you have any legal issues or your friends or family who need free legal assistance, we encourage you to reach out to Community Legal Services. You can either, I have our contact information here, or you can talk to Ping and she can connect you to me directly.
然后他就说了他的、他们、除了他今天会讲的这个主题之外，他们其实他们、机构也是有很非常广的这个服务范畴了、基本上所有范围你可以想得到了，他们都是有帮忙的。有些就是、他们会很多都是一些法律的问题，他们都会有一个律师去帮忙的、所以如果需要的话是可以去找他，等一下会有他的联系在这个上面，也可以联系我、我、去帮你们去做一个、连接。
Okay, so the first thing we're going to talk about are the two documents that are relevant while you're alive. We divide estate planning documents into the ones that are relevant while you're alive and the other ones that are relevant after someone passes away.
然后他现在主要、现在先讲呢，就是说有两个文件是、在你、还在、在世的时候、需要这些文件是对你是非常有用的。然后他们也有一些文件是如果这个人去世了，这些后事的这些处理方面该怎么办，然后另外有一些文件的。
Okay, so there's two documents that are important while someone is alive. The first one is called a power of attorney. That means you're giving somebody the authority to act if you become incapacitated, if you are unable to make decisions for yourself. This is particularly relevant to financial decisions.
然后他说第一种、就是这个授权书、okay? 这个授权书是这个人还在世的时候、有效了、okay? 通常这一个就是给某人，就是给一个人这个权利去处理，基本上最主要的就是这个财务的这个决定。
So if you give somebody power of attorneyto make financial decisions for you, you are giving them a very broad authority. They can make any financial decision that you would have been able to make, they can make for you.
如果你是授权一个人去帮你就是做这些财务确定的话，基本上你是给了他们非常非常大的，就是比较广泛的这个权利的。他们是可以去帮、去带你，你帮你去做很多的这些、财务上面的确定。
And this only takes effect if you become incapacitated. And if you become incapacitated and then you, for instance, from an illness or injury, and then you regain capacity, it's no longer in effect. It can start and then stop during your lifetime.
然后这一个基本上呢，只是当这个、 授权是只是在这个人是受伤还是疾病的时候，就是没有这个能力去做这些决定的时候才有效的。可是当这个人是恢复过来的话，这个授权书就是没没用就是没有不生效的。
And like with all estate planning documents, we're going to ask that you name not only a power of attorney, but an alternate power of attorney. So that if the person you chose is unavailable or unwilling to act, there's somebody else who could become your power of attorney.
Yeah, 他们也是建议在这些就是除了一个之外，你们应该也去找一个去找一个是替代的。就是如果这一个你授权的这个人他没办法找到他，还是说这个人不愿意去帮你去做的话，你还有一个替代的人可以去帮你做。
Okay, King, next slide, please.
Okay.
The other document that's relevant during your lifetime is called an Advanced Healthcare Directive.
然后另外一个就是也是你做在世的时候就是可以做就是有提就是叫提前医疗保健指令。
So, financial power of attorney was where you gave somebody the authority to make financial decisions for you. An advanced healthcare directive means you're giving somebody the authority to make healthcare decisions for you.
刚才说的授权书是这个帮忙去做这个财务的确定，现在这一个医疗保健指令啊，就是说帮你做这个医疗的决定的。
So like with a financial power of attorney, we'd ask that you select both a primary agent and an alternate agent, so that if the first person is unavailable or unreachable, that there's somebody else who can act.
因为他们就是跟刚才一样的，你是可以就是指定一个人，一个可以找得到也可以可靠的，可是也希望就是可以再有一个替代，就是以防万一，就是一个这个人是没办法没空啊，还是没办法帮忙的，就是还有一个可以就替代。
And in this document, you're giving your healthcare agent broad authority.But you're also giving them some guidance about what kind of healthcare interventions you would like.
这个基本上你也是给他，就是你在这个指令里边，你会说你是想需要什么样的物理，还是说就是如果当你是没能力的时候，你是需要什么样的物理还是医疗干预？
And again,This only takes, the way we draft it is that it only takes effect if you become unable to make your own medical decisions.
通常这个写的时候就是说明是这个只是有效的只会在你没办法去做这些没能力的时候才会生效的。
Okay. Next slide, Ping. Thank you. So that...concludes the section on documents that are relevant during your lifetime. Now we're going to turn to a longer section on wills, but I'd like to know if anyone has any questions they want to ask right now about the documents that are relevant while someone is alive.
刚才他说了就是说你在生活的时候 OK 你需要的文件 OK 然后他等一下会讲一些死后的这个遗产规划的文件有什么律令是比较多一点的，可是他现在想停一下，就是看看大家有没有什么问题是关于刚才说的这个指令还有这个授权的现在是可以问，有一个有问题的话是可以去问一些这些问题，也可以在聊天里边也可以举手okay. So actually, Anna, I do have questions. So for the powers of attorneys and also the medical directive, so how does that make it legal? Like, does it need to be notarized or does it need to bring it to somebody or register?
That's a smart question. Yes, those documents are notarized. Different states have different rules, and so it is always our recommendation that both documents get notarized, because that way, if you happen to be in a state that requires notarization, like if you're in New York or New Jersey, you want to make sure that you are following the state rules for where you are. So we recommend notarization as a best practice. But you don't need to file them with the court. They're just a private contract that you draft with yourself and then the person who you're giving authority to act on your behalf.
刚才我问他的问题就是说这些文件他刚才说的这两律文件是不是需要公证还是需不需要去法庭去让就是有人去把它就是传档起来他就是说不同的州他们是不同的规矩的所以他通常是建议这两律的文件都是去做一个公证 OK， 这样子如果是有一个州是需要公证的话，你就已经是有了啊。可是他说是不需要去什么法庭去把它存档啊，还是什么？这个是不需要的。OK， I don't see any question. I do have a follow-up. I think you actually run into a lot in our agency. Somebody like a seniors, maybe it was their daughter or son that helping them to apply for benefit and other stuff. Like a lot of time, but we don't really see these clients. So what would be the best way? I mean, would power attorney enough? Or like, I mean, what is the best way? Because we don't know if we're applying for this person a lot of time. So we usually request the client to be present when we're helping them to apply. So what would be the best suggestion for these situations?
That's such a great question. And for something like that, I would recommend a power of attorney. Mm-hmm. And not when we draft a power of attorney, we typically draft it only to take effect when somebody becomes incapacitated. But for you, you would want one that just can take effect at any point so that that person, the family member or friend can assist even though the other person is not actually incapacitated. But you may want to make it limited. Like you may not want to give somebody full financial authority to do anything like access someone's bank account, rent an apartment, pay bills. You might want to have like a more limited power of attorney that just says, I give authority, for instance, I, Anna Brickman, give authority to Ping to apply for benefits on my behalf and make it more limited.
OK, 我刚才问有一个问题问他，是因为我们公司很多时候看到有些老人家他们的子女去过来帮他们去申请这些福利，可是有时候我们就不知道这个是真的是这个长姐需要申请还是这个子女去帮他们去申请，所以我们通常都需要把人过来的，所以我说我怎么可以证明这个真的是授权他们去呢？他说其实就是还是建议有一个授权书，通常如果他们写的时候。 就是可以有很多写法，他们通常他们需要一般写的，就是说这个没有能力的情况之下，才会生效的。可是也可以写，就是说可以说没有上限的，就是说任何情况都可以帮忙去做这些。可是问题是也是需要有一个上限，有一个限制，有可能你不想给他们说一个完全有能力去帮你开银行账户啊，就是处理就是财务方面的。 OK， 所以可以很简单说，我授权这个人去帮我申请这个福利啊，还是做什么，然后就是一个公证这样子，就这个人就可以帮你，不用经常被人说就是说不知道是不是你啊，就是刁难嘛 ，OK， 所以如果有这一封信的话，就是做什么事就比较顺的。OK， so I actually still see if there's anybody. OK，
there's a question in the chat.
Yes.
And the answer is yes. It is our strong recommendation that everybody have an advanced healthcare directive so that if you ever become so injured or ill that you can't make your own decisions, that there is somebody designated to make decisions for you. Mm-hmm.
对，刚才呢，就是在聊天里边呢，有人问，就是关于这个医疗的这个指令，是不需要这个配偶还是家庭的人，需不需要有这个指令才可以帮忙？Anna 说是强力建议的 ，OK， 因为如果这个人是真的是生病了，这就是去。 去到一个程度是说没办法做这个医疗确定的话，这样子因为有这个指令，就有一个人是可以做一个确定。So I just want to give them an example because I think it happened to my father-in-law. They have he has a lot of sons and daughter, four sons and daughter. So as you said, if there's no like medical directive, so if somehow that nobody at we don't know who will be the final decision if there's a, not a, a cohesive decision.
Exactly. And then family members may argue. And not only does it designate what family member, it may also indicate what kind of care somebody would want in case they get really, really sick. And do they want something like a ventilator or CPR or a feeding tube? You get to make your wishes known to your family so they know how to make these really hard decisions.
Yeah. 因为有些人可能不想，我不想就是那么服了，OK，你就不要抢救了，还是就是可以去承担他的想法嘛，OK。我看到有人去 unmute了，是不是有问题？ I saw somebody unmute. I don't know if that person had questions. 你好，是不是苏西慧的 iPad 是有问题吗？有没有问题？我就先把你静音。
没有问题的。哦，OK，好，我先把你静音了。OK，OK，I
okay, okay, don't see any questions, so Anna, I think we can actually just go move on.
Sorry, I muted myself. Next slide, please.
Okay，好，我现在就让他去接着下去讲嘛。啊，又再有问题可以在聊天里边打，也可以到最后的问。Okay,
we're going to take a deep dive in the next few slides. Into what is in a will. So a will is a document where you get to state your wishes for what happens to your property and your belongings after you pass away.
然后他现在呢，可能之后几个几页都是比较深入的去讲一些这个遗嘱是什么了。OK，遗嘱他基本上就是可以让这个人去说，我去世之后期望我的财产，还有我的财产啊，我的物业这些是怎么样的。So
you identify who you want to have inherit your house. And any your assets, your bank accounts, your house, your car, the items that are in your home, who you want to have identify all of those, who you want to have inherit all of those items.
然后呢，基本上你这个人可以去指明说，我如果去世的话，我的资产财产就是包括银行账户里边的钱啊。 车啊，房子啊，还有这个房子里边的东西，我是希望谁去继承这些东西的。You're
going to select a person who's going to be responsible for paying any debts that you have, using your money to pay any debts that you have, and also distributing your property the way you want it distributed.
然后你会指定一个人。 OK，如果你有任何的债务，这个人也是可以用你的财产去帮你付这些钱的。然后还有就是，当然就是你这个房子啊，这些是期望谁去得到，还是需要怎么做？A
will is also very important because it can prevent fighting among your family members because you are clearly stating who is going to get what. They don't need to fight over it.
然后他也是这个啊，维举也是非常重要，就是去避免就是有争吵发生的。OK，因为你清楚的指明说你这一个房这些东西是希望谁去继承的。And
wills help prevent what we call tangled title, which is when you pass away, and it's unclear who owns your home. After you pass away. And that's one of the ways that people in Philadelphia lose their homes is when someone passes away and it's unclear who now owns the house.
Yeah, 就是一个去世的话，还可以避免这个斗劫的产权，就是不知道这个房子到最后是谁继承的。因为有些人他去世的时候是不清楚这个房子是给谁的，这个是谁继承的，这个其实是沸腾里边有沸也是比较普遍的一个绿营。为什么有些人是？ 就是这个房子没有了，因为这个房子到最后都不知道是谁的。Now
we're going to get very specific about the different parts of a will.
他现在会非常在仔细去讲这个遗嘱里边是有什么部分的。Okay,
we can just go to the next slide and jump right in. Okay, so one part of the will is called the executor.
然后其中第一部分呢，就是这个继承人。
The executor is a trusted person who's going to do the work of actually going to the register of wills to probate your estate, and then that's the person who will distribute your property.
然后这个继承人呢，他是会基本上就是就是的人，OK，他会就是去到这个register will，就是这个遗嘱的这个登记处，就是去登记你的这个遗嘱啊，然后就是这些东西是怎么分配的，他都会去帮你分配的。You
should choose an executor who is organized and reachable. And if possible, somebody who's located in Philadelphia, but that's not a requirement.
他们建议就是说你要找这个人需要是非常有组织能力的，也可以去找得到他了，所以最好这个人是住在费城这里的，就是最好，可是也不是说一定要在费城地区的。You
do not have to choose somebody who's a relative to be your executor. You can just choose a trusted friend.
你不一定需要找家庭的人去做这个执行人的，你也可以是一个可以相信得过的这个朋友也可以。Like
always, we're going to suggest that you choose an alternate executor as well in case the first one is unable to act.
就是跟之前两个文件一样了，他也是应该要找一个是替代的。 执行人就是说，如果第一个这个执行人他们不愿意去帮忙，还是说没办法的话，还是可能已经过世了，OK，那么你就可以这个替代的人去帮忙。We
want to caution you that an executor can seek to be paid for his or her time, although we rarely see that. It is something they could request.
然后就是让大家知道一下，就是说这个执行人是可以去收你钱的，因为他们要付出一些时间，他们是可以收这些钱。虽然他们也不是经常见到这个执行人去收钱的，可是就是让大家知道是有可能发生的。Okay,
next slide, Ping. Thank you. So the specific bequest clause, that's where you will make a list of your things and who you want to give them to.
然后甚至它里边还有一个叫特定遗赠条款，它这一个部分就是你去列出来究竟有什么东西你是要捐赠给别人的。So
typically in this section of the will, people list their house, if they have one, their car, their bank account, and any other objects that are important to them, maybe something they inherited from their parents or grandparents or their wedding ring, but really it's about their house, their car, and their bank accounts.
通常这些人家里边列出来的就是会是他的房子啊、车啊、银行账户啊，然后还有可能其他特殊有意义的物本，就是这样，有可能是从上上上上一代继承下来的这个可能结婚戒指啊这些，可是通常主要的就是房子、车还有银行账户。Like
with everything else, we suggest that you name an alternate in case any of the beneficiaries have passed away before you and they're not able to inherit.
当然了，跟其他一样呢，就是你除了说啊，这个是给这一个人的，你当然也有一个期待的。如果你第一个继承人他啊，被在你之前过世的话，你要有另外有一个人是可以替代的。
Next slide, please. The residuary clause. This is the part of the will that is sort of a catch-all that will cover everything else that you own that wasn't mentioned in the specific bequest clause.
然后还有一个叫剩余条款 ，OK， 这个基本上就是会包含你刚才在之前这个特别条款里边提到的，都会在这个剩余条款里边的。
So typically, what falls into this category are if you have any small bank accounts that you forgot to mention, or maybe the household belongings that actually are contained within your home.
然后呢，他就是说，包括是可能你有一些其他银行里边有很小很小的钱啊，然后可能是这个你家里边的家私啊，这些都是可以包含在里边的。
And you could choose to leave this to the same person you left your other items to, or to different people.
然后你也可以把它留给是刚才说的是同一个人，也可以是不同的人都可以的。
All right, next slide, please. We encourage, this is not mandatory, but we encourage you to include a funeral clause in your will.
然后它当然你也可以加一个这个葬礼的这个条款 ，OK， 你也可以不加你也可以加进去的。
And in that section, you write what your plan is, if any, for a funeral. So, have you already paid for a burial plot? Is there a specific funeral home you want to use? Do you wish to be buried or cremated? You don't have to include this information, but if you have it, we encourage you to include it.
那里边你就是可以说你过世之后你期望是怎么样的，有没有计划，你有没有计划，你有没有付款就是预留一个位置，还是说有没有这个就是有没有这个是什么OK， 你是期望火葬还是土葬的，还是说你有没有已经付了一个这个就是付钱了，这些都可以在里边讲清楚了。
Next slide, please.So I just talked about sort of the basics of what goes into a will. Now I'm going to talk through some of the questions that we most frequently receive about writing a will.
他讲的是比较就是基本的这个资料现在他会讲一些就是经常被人他们被人问到的关于遗嘱的问题。
What if I have already written a will?
那第一个问题就是说，如果我已经写了遗嘱，那么怎么样呢
？Ask yourself if your last will reflects your current wishes. Are the beneficiaries and the executors you listed still alive?
他就是说，如果你有遗嘱的话，你要看一看，就是想一想这个遗嘱是不是最后立的这个遗嘱有没有去反映你最现在期望的。东西，然后这个遗嘱承受人的 ，OK， 还有这个执行人，他现在还是不是在世
？And if your old will doesn't reflect your current wishes, then we suggest you write a new will.
如果你现在的这个遗嘱跟你自己想的东西是不一样的话，他就是建议你可能去再做一个遗嘱。
And if you write a new will, we suggest that you find old copies of your old will and shred them.
如果你是想重新写一个遗嘱的话，他建议你去找把旧的找出来，然后把它碎掉。
Okay.
And actually, there's a question I think is related to this.
Okay.
我看到聊天里边有说执行人不在了，这个遗嘱还有效吗 ？Okay. Someone asked if the executors is no longer alive, so is the will still effective?
That's a good question. If you know you have a will and the executor, both the executors or all of the executors that you named, because you typically name one and then an alternate, if they have died, we strongly, 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 strongly recommend that you write a new will.
Okay. 他说你刚才这个问执行人不在了这个为主还有效吗？这个是非常非常好的问题。他们是如果这个执行人是不在了，他是非常非常强力的去建议你重新再立一个。
But to be specific, yes, the old will is valid, but they're going to name the person who you designate in your residuary clause. They're going to name that person to be your new executor unless you write a new will.
Okay. 他就是说，如果你是没有重新再立一个为主，把就是把这个执行人换了，他会如果真的是有什么事发生的话，他会看你刚才这个叫附加的这个人，谁可以得到你剩余的条款的里边的剩下来东西的这个人去做这个执行人，所以他们是期望最好就是你如果期望另外有一个执行人的话，就是再立一个为主。OK.
Next slide, please.
Okay.
I have several slides ping on homeowners. Do you know if any of our participants are homeowners?
他说他有几个页是关于房主的，他想问一问，在家现在有没有谁是房主的？ I think so, because I think we do have clients that well, usually we people buy house, our community is big on buying house. So I believe that we do have homeowners. 我就跟他说, 基本上我们的人都喜欢买房子的。 所以应该我们是应该有房主，我自己就已经是其中一个。 Yeah, I told them including myself is also a homeowner too.
Okay, all right, great. Should I leave my home to all of my children or only one of my children?
应该有一个问题说，你的房子你是应该留给所有的孩子都有份，还是说只留给一个孩子？
Leaving your home to more than one person can lead to complications.
他说你把房子留给 几个人有可能有一个是比较麻烦的。
The future owners may not be in agreement about what to do with the house.
未来的这些房主有可能他们几个没办法达到一个同意去说这个房子该怎么办。
Each future owner could demand to be bought out of the house, and if the others can't afford it, then the house would have to be sold.
Okay, 他说每一个这个未来的房主可能要筹把这个房子买，所以 just want to clarify, what does that mean by bought out?
Great question. If you and I own a home together, at any moment I could demand that I could say I don't want to own the home anymore, and I would say give me, let's, if the home is worth $100,000, give me half the value of the home, and I give up my ownership. I will could ask to be bought out, saying I don't want to own it anymore. Oh, okay. So give me my money.
Okay, 他说为就是这几个房主有可能 OK， 其中有一个两个还是说哦我不想要个房子了，OK，你们付钱给我，我就退出来了，OK， 可是这些另外的房主可能没有这个钱去把这个房子完全买下来。
And with multiple owners, it's difficult to obtain a new mortgage.
然后如果有几个人都是房主的话，如果你要贷款就比较困难的。But
leaving a house to multiple owners and writing a will and leaving the house to multiple owners is better than not writing a will at all.
他说你有写遗嘱，说把这个房子给几个人。 怎么样也是比完全没有为主的好。Okay.
Next slide, please. Life estates. Could I let my son live in my house while he's alive and then give the house to my daughter?
另外有一个问题就是说我 Okay, 我可以让我的儿子住在这个房子，在他有生在生的时候啊，住在这个房子。可是这个房子是留给我女儿的。
You can, so the answer to that is yes, you can give a person a life estate to live in your home. They don't own a home. Someone else has ownership.
你是可以把这个房子就是给叫，就是成一个生命的财产，就是说这个住，活着的时候可以住在这个房子里边。
However, this arrangement, while it works for some, can get complicated.
Okay，这个人住在你房子，可是这个房子这个人是没有不就是不是这个房主的。Okay，你是可以这样子做，可是有可能比较变成非常复杂的问题。
For instance, the person with the life estate may fail to pay upkeep or real estate taxes.
有可能这个人是在生的时候，他是没办法去付这个房地税啊、保险啊，也没办法把这个房子弄好。
Or the person who you give the life estate to may take poor care of the home.
然后这个人也有可能不会很好的去照顾这个房子。
And with a life estate, you're not going to be eligible for the same city programs that a full owner is eligible for.
然后这个儿子，因为他有这个叫做生命财产的，OK，他有可能不合资格得到一些市政府的计划，因为他不是一个真真正正的房主。Okay, so I saw.
There's a question.
Oh, I think this one was talking about, I'm not sure, well, you can think about whether we want to answer it here or later. I think she's asking a remarry, okay, remarry, but they don't want to give their assets or property to the person, but want to actually leave it for the kid. Okay, how should they do?
That's a really good question. Let's come back to that. If at the end of, we talk about things related to that.
Okay.
So let's come back to that.
Okay.
Good question.
他说这个问题是很好的，可是他说等一下的话，他可能会讲到，所以可能把这个楼道最后的时候，一个还没回答的话，他会回答的。Okay, yes.
All right, next slide. What if my children are minors?
就是如果我的孩子是未成年人怎么办?
It is possible to put a house in trust for your minor children until they turn 18.
他说是可以把这个房子放到这个叫信托吧，信托就是有一个基金的，就是把它放到里边，直到他们比较年纪大一点的。
However, leaving property to children carries risks.
可是把房子留给这些小孩的话是有风险的。
So the child who inherits the house is responsible for the mortgage, taxes, and repairs.
然后他这个房子继承这个房子的话，这个人继承这个房子是需要负责任去付这个贷款啊、地税啊、装修啊这些事的。
A child cannot navigate doing those kinds of things, and a child is prohibited from selling or transferring property.
他说孩子是没办法承担这些责任的，还没办法去办理这些东西，还有未成年的人是没办法去买卖 ，OK， 就是转把这个转给别人也不行的。
If you have a disabled child, you should speak to a specialized attorney who works with what are called special needs trusts.
然后如果你想留给孩子，可是这个孩子也是残障的话了，他们CLS他们是没办法帮你去弄这些，就是起草这些文件的，你需要去找一个律师是专门是处理这些特殊需要的这些问题的。
Next slide, please. But I'm married. Doesn't my spouse already get half of everything? Can I disinherit my spouse? What if I get divorced?
Okay, 他这里有解，就是说，因为我结婚了， 那么我的配偶是不是不是已经得到一半了吗？也我可不可以就是就是不要我的配偶去继承我的东西？如果我离婚了怎么办呢？
Okay, this is a complicated one, but I'll give you some basics. But if you have specific questions, at the end of this, let's come back, ask them to me and we'll come back.
Okay. 他说这些其实有很多不同的这个情况。OK, 他也没办法所有情况都可以去帮就是回答得了的。可是他是有一些基本的可以讲，因为到最后有些更复杂的没有回答需要回答了，他到最后的时候可以会回答。
So oftentimes spouses choose to leave their property to one another.
很多时候他就是结婚的夫妻，他们是把财产就是给对方的。
However, you cannot disinherit your spouse.
可是你是没办法剥夺你配偶的继承权的。
If you try to disinherit your spouse, they have the right to claim 1/3 of your property.
如果你是尝试去把他们的继承权剥夺的话，他们是有权去申领三分之一的财产的。
If you get a divorce after you draft your will, we strongly suggest drafting a new will.
如果你是你是离婚了，在你就是起草这个遗嘱之前之后 ，Okay, let me try to figure it out. So divorce after you draft your will. So you draft your will first, and then you get divorced.
Yeah.
Okay. 如果你是起草了一个遗嘱之后离婚了，他是建议你去重新起草一个新的遗嘱。Okay.
Next slide, please. What if I owe money when I die?
然后现在问题就是说，如果我死的时候我有欠钱怎么办呢？
Your executor must pay your debts before distributing the assets in your estate.
你的继行人他是需要先用你的钱，你的财产去付完这些账单了，这些欠钱之后才可以把你的财产分配出去的。
We strongly advise that you tell your executor about any debts that you have.
他就是强烈建议你去跟这个执行人去讲，提前讲，就是你有什么的欠款是他们有可能需要付的。
And sometimes a house must be sold in order to pay off debts.
有可能有时候这些房子需要卖掉了，才可以去把这些债务还清的。
Next
so,
slide, please.
Yeah, I do want to follow up question is like, what happened if, like, for example, did not tell the secretary, okay, I have these debt, okay? So what will happen if it's not paid at that point?
They can actually come after your executor. The creditors can come after your executor.
Okay, 我刚才问的问题就是说，因为他建议就是跟这个执行人去讲你有什么债务嘛。那么如果没有跟他讲等一下，可是如果是没有跟他讲，然后这个执行人有可能是不知道没有付的话，会怎么会发生什么事？他就说只是债务可能去就是跟着你跟着就是去追讨，就是跟这个执行人去追讨只是债务的。Okay.
Who will receive my life insurance and or pension?
谁会得到我的人寿保险还有养老金呢？
Life insurance and pensions are one of the few things or some of the few things that don't pass through your will.
这个人寿保险还有养老金呢，这个是就是其中几样是不包含在这个遗嘱的权利里边的。
When you tell your life insurance or pension company who you want that money to go to, and it automatically goes to them.
你是需要你通常你人寿保险还有养老金的话，你会跟他们说你希望你过世的时候这些钱是给谁的。
And also some types of social security disability pass outside of the will as well.
然后有时候有些就是这个血安的这个残疾保险的话，这个有可能就是 SSDI 这些啊是不包含在这个维族可以放这个范畴里面的。
Next slide, please. What if I have a mortgage on my house when I die?
那么如果我去世的时候，我房子还有贷款怎么办呢？
The mortgage does not go away.
这个贷款不会走的，还是不会因为你死了就免掉的。
And if the beneficiary, the person who inherits your home, if they don't pay it, then the house could go into foreclosure.
他们可能要求你继承你这个房子的人去借着去付这个贷款。
We advise beneficiaries to contact community legal services if they inherit a house that has a mortgage.
他就是，然后如果这个人不付的话，这个贷他这个房子可能没没收了，所以他们建议，如果你是这个继承人继承这个房子，可是有贷款需要付的，他建议去联系CLS。
Okay, next slide, please. How much are inheritance taxes?
就遗产税是多少了？
The inheritance taxes are a percentage of the value of the property you're transferring.
这个遗产税是根据这个遗产，就是这个这个遗产是值多少钱里边的一部分，是有一个百分比的。
And they range from 0% of the value to 15% of the value, depending.
Okay, sorry. 它可以是0-15% 的。
So that they range from 0-15% depending on how close the family relation is that you're transferring to.
他说是0-15% 是根据这个。继承人跟这个去世的人他的关系有多近。
If you are low income, there are grant programs that we can help you access to pay these costs.
如果你是低收入的话呢，是有一些计划是可以帮你付这个遗产税的。
Okay, next slide. Can I avoid inheritance taxes by adding my child's name to the deed?
我可不可以避免去，就是为了避免这个遗产税，遗产税就在我的这个房子的这个地契上面加我孩子的名字了？
We strongly advise against doing this.
他是强力不建议去在地契上加你孩子的名字去避免这个遗产税了。
If you add somebody's name to your deed, it's basically the same as giving away your property.
你如果加其他人的名字在你的地契上，其实就跟你把这个房子给他是一样的。
That new joint owner has the same rights to the house as you do.
这个新的这个房子，这一起的这个房主，他是跟你的权利是一模一样的。
They could also file a partition and force the sale of the home.
然后他这个人也可以是去去要求这个买卖这个房子，然后把你贴出去的。
It could also make you ineligible for city programs.
然后你加了这个人名字之后，有可能把你就是先以前合资格申请的这些计划，现在都不合资格了。
And it could even make you ineligible for Medicaid.
他们你加了他的名字，也有可能把你变成原来你是可以得到政府医疗的，可是之后都没办法拿到政府医疗了。
So we strongly advise not to add somebody's name to the deed of your home.
他是强力建议不要在你的这个地契上去加别人的名字的。
Instead, you should just write a will and say who you want your home to go to when you pass away.
然后就是你应该是写遗嘱说你这个房子是想交给谁的。
Next slide, please. similar question. Can I skip a will and just add my child's name to my bank account?
跟刚才的问题差不多，就是我可不可以不立这个遗嘱，就直接把我孩子的名字加到我的银行账户里边？
We advise against this.
他是不建议你的。
Like with the house, the joint owner of the bank account has all the same rights to the money as you do.
就像房子一样，这个联合的账户人民人的话，他是跟你的权利是一模一样的，就是你的钱的话，他是有权做任何的事。
The joint owner could withdraw all the money, and that would be okay.
他们可以随时随地的就把你所有的钱都转出来了。
Their creditors could come after the money, like if they have, they're in a car accident or they have medical debt.
然后这个联名人他的这个债务人，OK，也有可能去拿这些钱的，就像如果有交通意外啊，还是说有这个医疗的债务的话，都是可以拿这些用这些钱去付的。And
shockingly, you need the permission of the joint owner to take them off the bank account once you've added them.
然后还有最重要一点很惊讶的，就是说需要这个联名人的批准，才可以把他们拿掉，从这个账户里边拿掉了。Next
slide, please. Should I tell my family what's in my will?
我需要跟我家庭家里的人说我的遗嘱里边是怎么写吗？
Our advice is yes.
他们的意见是yes，是需要的。
We suggest that you talk to your family about what's in your will so that nothing is a surprise.
他们建议你是跟他们说你的遗嘱里边是写什么，是讲什么的，这样子他们就不会就是一个特完的事。
And it makes clear that the will truly represents your wishes and that you did not make it under coercion.
然后就是可以很清楚地表达到这个遗嘱里边是真的是你的意愿来的，就不是说特完发生的时候就是不清醒的状态去立的这个遗嘱。Next
slide, please. Where should I keep my will and other documents?
我需要把这个遗嘱还有其他文件放在哪里啦？
Keeping the original will is very important. You should put it in a safe and dry place.
他说这个原本，这个正本是需要放到一个非常安全还有干燥的地方。
You should tell your executor, your power of attorney, and your healthcare agent where you are storing your documents.
你要跟你的执行人啊，就是代理人啊，还有这些人，就是说你的文件是存到哪里的。We
will give you copy, or any attorney, whether it's CLS or another attorney, will give you copies of these documents to give to your executor and your healthcare agent and your power of attorney.
通常律师还有他们 CLS 都会的，就会给你一些副本，就是这些文件的副本。
But keeping the originals is very important. You need the original will to go probate your estate and go to the register of wills.
他说你的正本是非常重要的，因为你是需要，当你去登记你的这个遗嘱的话，你是必须要拿正本的。Okay.
Next slide, please. Okay. So that's the end of my presentation, but let's talk about next steps and then answer your questions.
So 刚才说了，就是他今天想讲的，可是就也可以，就是现在就是说下一步怎么办呢？
If you're interested in getting these documents drafted, which I hope you all are, you can either contact Community Legal Services or the Bar Association Lawyer Referral Service.
他说，如果你是有兴趣去立这个遗嘱的，他也希望大家都是会去做这个。你可以联系他们社区法律服务，也可以联系有一个叫律师的这个机构，他们是可以帮忙的。
So, if you want, CLS has requirements of who we will work with.
他说他们社区法律部门服务是有要求说他们谁可以帮忙的。
One, you have to be a homeowner for us to draft your will and other documents.
第一是你必须是房主，他们才可以帮你去立这些文件的。
Two, you have to be low income, but if you feel like you are probably low income or you live off of Social Security, then you're probably low income.
然后第二个条件就是需要是低收入的，所以尤其是如果是拿养老金这个退休金的这些，通常你都是合资格的。So
to confirm, if you are a homeowner and you are low income, we would be very happy to draft your will free of charge.
如果你是物主，然后也是低收入的，他们会很愿意去帮忙去你去起草这个遗嘱的。
If you are not a homeowner and or not low income, we recommend calling the Bar Association for the name of an attorney.
然后如果你不是房主，也不是低收入的话，还是不是低收入的话，你是可以联系这个 Bar Association，是这个律师协会，他们是会跟你帮你找一个律师的。
Ping, hopefully you can send out these phone numbers and email address to participants after this meeting so they have a record of how to reach us or how to reach the Bar Association.
Okay, if you don't mind, actually is this PowerPoint, can I share with the public?
Mm-hmm, that's fine.
Okay, yeah. 他就是希望我会把这些联系的资料会分享给大家，然后我问他这个 PPT 我是不是可以跟大家分享的，他是说可以的。
But we strongly advise that you don't draft the will yourself.
Oh, just one second.
Is the laminated?
Yeah. Probably a little bit. Another 5 minutes? Okay. Yeah. Sorry. I think you were saying not to.
We strongly advise that you don't draft the will yourself.
Okay, I think that also answered one of the questions on the chat too.
Yes.
Yeah. 他就是强烈建议，就不推荐说你自己去起草这个遗嘱。
There are certain requirements that the law requires, and if you don't draft your will or other documents according to those requirements, then they won't be valid and they won't be accepted.
他说这个例如这个遗嘱，他州政府只有规矩说这个遗嘱是要有一些标准是一定要达到的，因为没有达到这个标准的话，他这个遗嘱可能是没效的。And
we don't want you to be in a position where you think you've drafted everything and then actually you're incapacitated or you've passed away and those documents are being rejected.
他们就是不想你自己去立这个遗嘱，然后之后你是可能没能力去就是做决定啊，还是说你过世了，然后你写一个文件是没效了，那么就没用了。
And if you're low income, we'll do it for you for free.
如果你是低收入的话，他们是会免费的去帮忙去起草这个文件的。
I'm sorry, I should have said low income and a homeowner. We'll do it for you for free. But there are other agencies in the city that will also do it for low income people.
Okay, 他说他们 CLS 就是会帮房主低收入的房主是可以免费起草了，可是费城地区也有其他人是会可以免费帮忙去起草这些文件的。
Does anybody have any more questions?
他就是说有没有谁还有问题？ Actually, so I just want to just get a clarification. So all these documents, okay, so after we draft, we notarize. Mm-hmm. So I will believe the wills also need to be notarized?
Yes, we strongly advise the wills are notarized. And if we draft them, that's part of the process.
Okay.
We come to our office and we have a notary and witnesses.
Okay. So they don't need to actually file somewhere else. It will just draft and then have the proper notarized or witnesses, and then it should be valid.
Correct.
Okay. 对，我刚才就是问他，就是再清楚一点，就是刚才说的这些文件，你是不需要去法庭还是哪里的？ 你只需要把它起草了，然后里边有签字啊，有就是可能有公证啊，然后他们说如果在他们哪里做的话，他们也会把啊，就是不需要付这个啊公证费用，他们就是有人去帮你公证，也有就是有啊证人证明这个是主办人签的，他都会有这些，就是然后之后这个啊为主啊这些啊代理的这些全部都是啊有效的了。Okay, so I see someone raising. So I just want to honor the time. So Anna, how much time do you have?
Whatever you need.
Okay. So I think someone's raising their hand. I'm going to just, yes. 我刚才就是就是想就是尊重一些他的时间，因为他也是律师来的。他说他说我们他是可以再回答一些问题。他说都他时间上还有空。好，我刚才看到 Galaxy Note 9举手，你可以把你的声音打开。Galaxy Note 9，你要把你的声音打开，不然我们听不到你讲话。
我是想问，我父母有遗嘱和那个信托，如果他去世了，我怎么去执行这个把房子转到我这边来？
So I just want to make sure I'm going to stop recording because I think the main thing is already recorded. 我就是想说